knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
As we discussed previously, the five extant echinoderm classes are Crinoidea, Asteroidea, Ophiuroidea, Echinoidea, and Holothuroidea. In the previous tutorial, we covered the crinoids. In this tutorial, we will discuss Asteroidea and Ophiuroidea. Members of class Asteroidea are commonly known as sea stars, or starfish. There are nearly 2,000 described species of sea stars that are found in all the world's oceans, from the tropical zones to the polar regions, from the intertidal zones to the abyssal depths. They are perhaps the most familiar of the echinoderms, and many are opportunistic predators that feed on benthic invertebrates. Some of them, like the sunflower sea star, feed primarily on other echinoderms. As predators, they play an important ecological role, and areas where they have been removed have generally suffered due to overpopulation of prey species. For example, the purple sea star and the reef sea star have become widely known as examples of keystone species due to their ability to reduce mussel populations, and thus maintain a more biodiverse ecosystem. They move along the substrate using their hydraulic tube feet and feed by extruding their stomach through their mouths, thus beginning the digestion process outside of the body. Sea stars are able to reproduce asexually through fragmentation as long as part of the basal disc is preserved, and also sexually, usually indirectly, where both sexes release sperm and eggs into the water. However, some species do brood young that burst from the mother. Most species that do not give live birth release eggs that hatch into free-swimming bipinnaria larvae and metamorphosize into brachiolaria larvae, which in turn metamorphosize into sexually immature juveniles. The number of asteroid orders is a bit contested and was recently revised to include the sea daisies. As of 2023, there are 3 superorders and 8 orders. We have order Velatida, order Peripodida, superorder Forcipulitacea, which contains order Brisingida and order Forcipulitida, superorder Spinulocetia, which contains order Spinulocida, and superorder Valvatacea, which contains order Notomyotida, order Paxilocida, and order Valvatida. Previously, these 3 superorders were considered individual orders, and that may change again in the future, but let's briefly go over their diversity as it stands currently. Order Velatida contains about 200 species of starfish that have thick bodies and large oral discs. They are most common in the deep sea and colder regions. They are often extremely flexible and have weakly developed skeletons. Meanwhile, there are only 3 described species in order Peripodida, all of which are known as sea daisies that lack intestines and anuses. Less than 1 centimeter in diameter, they are disc-shaped animals with pentaradial symmetry and no arms. They are all found in the deep sea. Members of order Brisingida are filter feeders that generally have long arms, which always number more than 5, a small brittle star-like disc, and are most common in the deep sea. Order Forcipulitida includes the common starfish, which are extremely widespread in the Americas. They are some of the most familiar forms of starfish, with many species inhabiting coastal seas and intertidal zones. Members of order Spinulocetida completely lack pedicellariae, have numerous spines, and are often quite skeletally delicate. The last 3 orders are all under the superorder Valvatacea. First, there are the deep-sea-dwelling and flexible Benthopectinidae, the only family within order Notomyotida. Then there is order Paxilocida, which lack an anus and suckers on their tube feet and have immovable pedicellariae. And finally, order Valvatida, which is large and diverse, includes small species like the scarlet cushion star, only 5 centimeters in diameter, all the way up to the heavy starfish, which can weigh more than 6 kilograms, or 13 pounds, and grow to lengths of more than 65 centimeters, or 2 feet. They are characterized by their marginal ossicles, and adults often have 5 arms with tube feet. Next up, species in class Ophiuroidea are called brittle stars or basket stars. Of the more than 2,000 extant species of brittle stars, more than 1,200 of them are found in deep ocean waters. They are some of the most common animals in some types of benthic marine habitats, where they may carpet the floor in what appears to be a living mass. Though they superficially resemble the sea stars, they are remarkably different in form and function. Unlike the starfish, brittle stars have slender arms that are sharply set off from the central disk. They lack pedicellariae and papulae, and their ambulacral grooves are closed and covered in bony ossicles. They also have tube feet which lack suckers. So instead of tube feet for locomotion, they use their arms, which are made of a column of articulated ossicles, sometimes called vertebrae, which are connected by muscles and covered in plates. Also unlike the starfish, the brittle star madreporite is located on the oral surface by the mouth, which has 5 movable plates that serve as jaws, so they do not extrude their stomachs to feed. Most species feed on small suspended particles or dead or decaying organisms, but some species are carnivorous. Since their arms are so slender, nearly all of the brittle star organs are confined to the central disc. They have a sac-like stomach, no intestine or anus, and indigestible food is expelled through the mouth. They also have unique structures known as bursae that open towards the oral surface by genital slits at the base of the arms. These bursae circulate water for gas exchange and aid in the discharge of sex cells. Like the sea stars, the brittle stars are capable of extreme regeneration, and some species, like the six-armed members of family Ophiuroidea, can split their central disc in two and reproduce through fission. In most species, sexes are separate and fertilization is external. The fertilized eggs may develop to become 8-armed Ophiuroidea larvae, which metamorphosize into juveniles and then adults. The extant members of class Ophiuroidea are split up into 6 extant orders, those being Urialida, Ophiurida, Amphilopidida, Ophiacanthida, Ophiolucida, and Ophioscolicida. Members of order Urialida are commonly called basket stars and are large species with branching arms or long and curling arms, sometimes called snake stars. Meanwhile, members of the remaining orders are often simply referred to as brittle stars, use bursae for respiration and excretion, have their madreporite on the oral surface, and move their arms by using ball and socket joints. However, they do vary by order, habitat, and life history. With 3 echinoderm classes now covered, let's move forward and cover the remaining 2.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.